of the great singers, one of the great record sellers.
The old big disco sound. Today we have Donna Summer unplugged, acoustic. And this is one of the all-time great instruments.
Yes, great voice.
Her husband Bruce is going to be accompanying her on acoustic guitar, and we're going to have a real big treat here.
The definition of unplugged is?
No electronics involved, just an acoustic sound.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, she'll be microphoned, of course, but...
Yeah, okay. So anyway, Donna back, bigger than ever, and this is her new CD called Endless Summer. We'll have her on the show doing one of the cuts from that.
Now, the weirdest thing happened the other day.
What's that?
Yesterday, actually. I went home, and Christine, our nanny, said, Donna Summer's going to be on the show tomorrow. And I said, yeah, because we all love Donna Summer. And she said, the weirdest thing happened, she's a friend of mine, sold her dishes a while back up in Connecticut, mm-hmm. and she never came back for them.
Hmm.
Would you please let Donna know that... her dishes are waiting for her.
Why do we have to do that? Why don't we just keep the dishes? Just kidding.
Right there is the real difference.
The difference between us. Yes, he's a slow life, and I'm this good. Yeah, right. Sure. You believe that?
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
I mean, it just made you want to get up and dance, no doubt about it. For 20 years, she's been racking up hit after disco hit, and now you can hear all those hits again on her new album called Endless Summer. Here she is, the queen of disco herself, Donna Summer.
Hi, baby. How you doing?
Hi, Donna.
Donna Summer is here.
I'm so glad.
Holy cow.
You were great.
Oh, thank you.
Coming from
impressed.
You, that is a tremendous compliment.
When you win.
Thank you. Now, do you open your mouth that wide when you hit the high notes, too, or is it just easier for you?
No, I open it wide.
Yeah. You were doing your own Super Bowl concert down there, right?
Yeah, I think we did one for the radio, Apollo 106 or something down there. It was one of those outdoor things.
Yeah.
It was exciting. Not as exciting as yours, though, Kath.
Honey, I don't ever want to be that excited again as long as I live.
I was so nervous for you.
Oh, you and my mother. Thank you.
I really was. My knees were shaking. I said, hit the high note. Come on. Go on. Do it, girl.
You said a prayer for me.
I did.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, Regis.
Are we through applauding each other?
No.
Can we get on with real life now?
Let's get on with real life. What the heck is with the dishes? What happened here?
The
you
dishes?
Forgot your dishes. You bought some dishes up at a store near Greenwich?
Greenwich? In Westport?
Are you sure?
Westport.
Westport.
You got my dishes?
Somebody had to take them.
What happened is they brought them to my house.
Here they are, right here.
I hear your dishes.
I haven't found them in 3 years.
This award on behalf of my
but Donna, I mean,
they're
the dishes
horrible.
Were laying there for
Thank
3 years.
Okay.
You
I don't have
forgot?
A good memory.
You just forgot?
No. Actually, what happened was I went away on, I was touring, and then I came back, and the lady was gone that, you know, bed I bought the dishes from. And then I went back again, and she wasn't there again, and I couldn't find the slip. And I said, well, how am I going to explain to somebody that it's mine? And I kept going back, but the lady that sold them to me was never there.
Yeah.
So I just gave up on them.
Oh.
Well, you don't have to, Princess.
Well,
there
thank
they
you.
Are.
Let's talk about
those. I hauled those in with the dogs this morning. It was a busy day.
And those are busy dishes, too, Donna. I mean,
I think they're adorable.
You've got purple.
They're for breakfast, you know, like in the summertime.
In the summertime, yeah.
You know, like little something cheerful.
And you're getting ready to move, huh?
Want to move to Nashville real soon, yeah.
Can't wait.
Oh, I love it. I love
do
it.
You?
Yes,
what
I
do you love about it?
Well, you know, I've lived in L.A. for quite a few years, and I've never felt like I live there. I always felt like I was sort of just always stopping off and going somewhere. And in Nashville, I already feel like I'm part of the fiber of the community. They've invited me in. They've made me a part of everything. I love it.
Did it 2 years ago by Mr. Blackwell's house?
Oh, not 2 years ago. That was about...
Years ago.
Oh, years ago. Yeah, I bought it. Yeah, years ago.
I lived around the corner from you.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
all that,
yeah, sure.
And I didn't know...
Oh, no, I was at your house.
Sorry. You were?
She forgot me, too. Donna Summer forgets everything.
Were you there, really?
This was years ago, though, right?
She doesn't remember me.
Yes, I lived in
Hancock. You had a party there. I was there. Hi, Regis. Big kiss and then get me out. You know what I'm saying?
We did have a party. Yeah, that's right. There was a big party there. Who knows who was there?
Yeah. No, Blackwell had it. It was a lovely home. It was like a mansion.
It was a mansion. 26-room mansion.
So you're going down to Nashville. You're keeping your apartment here in New York.
I'm trying to sell it.
If she could remember where it is.
It's on the Upper East Side. It's on the Mid East. How did you ever remember all these lyrics, all these?
Yeah.
I don't. I forget them. I mean, as a matter of fact, I forgot the one I did the last weekend.
Yeah?
One of the songs I just...
Oh, yeah.
Blank, huh?
You know, people start yelling and you get distracted for a minute, sure. And all of a sudden it's like, where am I in the song? Yeah. The song keeps going even if you're thinking about something else. It's like terrifying to me.
What was it like in the heyday of disco? I mean, it must have been bedlam out there, huh? Everybody dancing and yelling?
Yeah, I think people think that it's a lot nicer than it is, but I think the hectic lifestyle and just the no private time and people pursuing you constantly... you know, the stalkers, the this-there, the that-ers, whatever all those things are, isn't pleasant.
You don't miss that.
Oh, no, that part of it I don't miss. I mean, there's always a certain portion of it that is in the business, but that hectic part I could live without.
Had you started singing before the disco thing hit?
I did musical theater in Germany.
Uh-huh.
I did Godspell Hair and Porgy and Bess. I mean, nobody knows.
Showboat.
And I wanted to act. You know, because singing I could do. I wanted to act. And,
sure.
And
See, just came
I
so naturally.
I still aspire to being an actress, you know.
And why not?
And why not? I mean, come on.
Nashville's not basically the place to live to pursue that sort of a career.
But you can live anywhere nowadays because they have faxes.
They do. I haven't gotten any. No, you're
facts
right.
Of life. Yeah. This is what
I'd love for some wonderful producer out there to realize, by golly, that's right, Donna Summer.
And you too.
No, not me.
Yeah. No, really, you sure. You've got so much passion. I saw you once at the Hollywood Ball. That place rocked like crazy.
Yeah,
you sang with
fun.
So much passion. Remember? You probably played that place a bunch of times.
I love that place. It was great. Hollywood Ball.
But I think one of the problems with the disco era is that the music was so overwhelming. The orchestrations were so overwhelming that your voice, which is one of the great instruments God has ever given, I mean, you could hear you hit the high notes and stuff, but I mean, you were never allowed a tender moment, basically. You were allowed orgasmic moments, but not tender ones.
She had to put that in, you know.
What?
She just had to put it in.
What was that like?
She is a real tender.
Because I haven't had one of those. Donna, what did you do before you became a singer? Did you have some civilian jobs in there?
Did I have civilian jobs? Just so people know that I suffered. I worked in a freezer once. I was in a meat packing plant.
Were you like a butcher? Or?
Oh, no, I just had to pack the meat.
Pack
meat. And put it in the freezer. And I stood in front of this ice-cold freezer inside of a freezing compartment with a coat on all day. Mm. And I packed the meat in. And after about 4 days, I just gave up. I said, no.
I'm going to sing.
That was it. Yeah, I was going to sing. Mm. And I didn't think it was good for my voice. And so then I worked at a hospital as one of those people that make
the
dietary aid.
Uh-huh.
This was not good either because I was giving people the wrong foods. Not good.
She'd forget what they were supposed to get.
Then I worked as a cake person I worked in a bakery, and I had to one day carry this big, huge wedding cake, and the swinging door swung this way. And as I went swinging, it banged me, and the cake went up, and I just couldn't catch the whole cake. It was not good.
Not good.
No, you were destined for the stage.
I had to. Yeah. I was desperate for the stage.
And when we come back, we're going to put her on stage right here.
Good.
We're going to sing On the Lady.